Hey guys, I got another knife. Can you believe it? This is what I've been waiting for a while. This is the Senrenmu 735. This is probably the worst state I've ever seen a Senrenmu knife come to me, which is really too bad. My people will fix it. We will see. Let's see here. So the knife is a flipper. And as you can see there, it has the flipper. It does not flip right now because it is so freaking tight that it is actually incredibly hard to open. And this is a problem because it's even hard to close. And if you can see this, yeah, I had to super glue that together because I didn't feel like getting stitches. So sliced it right down there. It's probably not in very good focus. See all the gruesome details. Come on, you can do it. Look at the gruesome detail. It's not really that bad. First thing went through my mind wasn't ow, it was Steve, you're stupid. I'm not even sure how it happened, but I wasn't being very careful, so I deserve it. But anyway, so it's kind of like the 710 in the metal frame, except this one has the I don't know what it is exactly, Zytel or some sort of plastic insert here, so it's not the flow-through design. It has got thumb studs, which again are slightly protruding past the handle. Another odd thing is that the pivot screw is entirely behind the pocket clip. And this is a problem, because in order for me to perhaps adjust some of this tightness out, I have to take that off. So I got to find my Torx screws, my Torx screwdriver, I should say. And I'm not sure where that is right now. So this thing came to me extremely tight, and now it is entirely possible that was intentional because of the flipper. And I know that Customs did open this knife. In fact, I do have a small clip that I took yesterday after I opened it showing the Customs tape. But I have really crappy editing software, so I don't know how it's going to look, the video's going to look with it. I'll try and edit it in there. We'll see what happens. Check it out. Canada Customs. Border Patrols. Opened up my knife here. This one. That's probably why it took me so long to get it. So yeah, like this thing, like, it hurts my finger to push on this to get it out that far. Another really bad thing, and this is probably the worst thing I've ever seen with the Senrenmu, is that, let's see if I can zoom in on this a bit better here. That lock, it's barely over the blade. I don't know if you can really tell. Just barely. And if you were to just slowly open it, it just doesn't come over, like, it just won't lock. You have to really flick it open hard just to get it to come over a little bit. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to be taking it apart anyway. Or can I take this apart? Yeah, that's just a pin. Should be able to take it apart. I'm going to find out anyway. And try and file that down a little bit, just a tad, just so I can get that lock of it over there. Because I don't feel very comfortable with it that way. But anyway, I got this thing for sheep's foot and Warncliffe blades. I'm not exactly sure why, but this thing here's got sort of a modified sheep's foot. That's what I'm going to call it. I mean, there's sheep's foot technically doesn't have a belly. It's supposed to be perfectly straight here, but a lot of people just call it modified sheep's foot. So the sheep's foot is really this blunt edge here that you find a lot in rescue cutters, and the entire point is that if you're going to cut someone's seatbelt off, you can rub the end up here right up against it, the person's skin or whatever, and you're not going to hurt them any more than they already are, because you're not going to be poking them in, because there's no real, you know, point to this thing. Now, because it has a belly, there is a tad of a point, a bit of a point to it, but generally speaking, I think this is a sheep's foot blade, and I really don't know what I like so much about them. But there's a couple more knives that are out there, like the Enlin, the M025 that I would like to get. And because I don't know what it is, I just love Wharncliffs and sheet foot blades. But I hate serrations, and that's what you usually find on sheet foot blades. So that's why I got this one, because I, you know, sheet foot, and it's not serrated. It's got that this like humongous lanyard hole, or usually lanyard holes are on the back of the knife. So I'm not exactly sure why this one's like this. If someone can enlighten me, that'd be great. The ergonomics are a little off on this one because of the way the flipper goes. When you, I don't know if it's just the way my fingers are, it's kind of uncomfortable to hold this knife. And it's not horrible, because you're not going to be, I don't know if you're going to be using this for any type of hard use. I'm actually going to try it as soon as I get this lock figured out. And the jimping on the top here, so far it seems to be semi-functional. Pocket clip works pretty good. I did try that out yesterday for after I received it. And you can see from the way my finger is, the knife is extremely sharp out of the box. Extremely. That took no effort at all, really, to slice my finger open like that. This flap was right open. It was bleeding everywhere. Glad no one saw it. Otherwise, I might have had to go to the hospital. I didn't really not want to get stitches. Didn't feel like it yesterday. So, that's my first impressions on this one. Now, I might be tainted. This could just be a bad, you know, a lemon. Because I honestly have never had any trouble with San Remus. And this is the first one. And I'm definitely not going to say that they're a bad company or that, you know. Because, I mean, it's just this one knife. It could be that everyone else's is just fine. It's just this one. You know, made through quality control or whatever. So, if I can fix it up, I think it's going to be a good blade. It's my only flipper blade, so I'm kind of really hoping that I can loosen up a bit. I did put oil in there, but it didn't work. I don't know if maybe it's just so tight, the oil never actually got into the, past the bushings there. So we'll find out. And then I really want a knife I can just flick open with a flipper. So anyway, that's my first impression so far. Don't cut yourself. Have a good day.